Going back to school is tough, and you might need some tools to help you succeed. You might be going to be a dentist, an accountant, an engineer, a doctor, or even a teacher. But what's important is knowing what kind of tech you need for your pathway to success, but still fits inside your budget. Because let's face it, those student loans aren't paying themselves. So let's get started with three things you probably, most likely, probably almost always need for school and for people who travel on the go. The most important item you need and what most people think of when they think of back to school is a good solid backpack. I know you might be thinking, well, that's just common sense. Well, there are a lot of different backpacks out there. Some look super stylish, but are just impractical. For example, just because it looks nice doesn't automatically mean it's a good choice to bring to school. So that's why when picking a bag, make sure it fits right, has all the features you need, and is within your budget. For examples of features, many bags include things like laptop sleeves, tablet sleeves, water bottle exterior strappy thingies, and built-in battery banks. Now you have to be careful with this kind of stuff. With backpacks that come with laptop or tablet sleeves, you have to make sure there's adequate padding around the area so that when you come home from work or school and you toss your backpack somewhere, it doesn't make a new paperweight. Tech ain't cheap. Also, don't ever, ever buy a built-in battery bank with a backpack. That makes absolutely no sense. Buy your own portable battery bank. It's usually cheaper and you can take that anywhere. And if you need it in your backpack, stick in your backpack, you're done. Voila. There's so many different types of backpacks out there that I can't really help you with a recommendation because everyone's different and they need specific things that may not apply to me. So do your own research, guys, and be careful with that. The next thing I want to recommend are these pair of wired earbuds. These, the Sony MDR XB50AP. Not everyone is using wireless headphones and earbuds. Having a wired pair as an extra is always nice, and considering that these are only 30 bucks and sound great for that price is amazing. Well, they're not always 30 bucks, but they're consistently on sale for 30 bucks. And if you can find it for that price, they're a complete steal. They sound better than any other headphone in that price range, at least in my opinion, for all the things I've tried. I do plan to do a full-on review video of these earbuds in the following weeks to come. If you're interested in that, then look forward to it. Okay, so if you're in college or a professional working business guy or girl, then you probably use a laptop on the go for the majority of your work. And chances are that laptop has a touchpad. Well, almost all laptops have touchpads, but you get the point. And not all trackpads are created equal. Some are great, amazing, fantastic, feel so natural, and others are poop, garbage, straight out of the sewer, nastiness. That's why there's this, the Logitech MX Mouse. Wait a second. This isn't a budget mouse. That's why there's this, the Logitech G602 wireless game. This is a gaming mouse with a lot of buttons. That's why there's this, the Logitech M325, or just kidding, any of these three mice would be great. One of them is a great overall productivity mouse with wireless features and great aesthetics with a similar price tag to match. One is wireless with gaming features and a lot of buttons for people who use hotkeys for those sort of things, like programmers. And the price tag is middle of the road. And the last one is wireless, portable, and cheap. Not gonna lie, I enjoy all three mice and they all serve different purposes. And this tiny one really puts life into perspective. It really humbles you after being able to hold such massive mice all the time. Oh, and it also comes in a lot of different colors and has a slightly larger older brother as well. So honestly, I'd look into that. Well, that concludes my three different things that you'll probably, most likely, almost always need for school and on the go. What do you guys think of this video? Was it useful, helpful to you in any way, or not at all? Leave that down in the comment section below. If you enjoyed this video, give it a thumbs up, and well, don't forget to subscribe. I'll see you guys next time.